would like to thank you for the opportunity to speak with you today about House Bill 294. This legislation would require the Ohio Department of Health to ensure that the funds it receives from the state or from a variety of federal funds are not used to perform or promote elective abortions. For example, if the ODH, Ohio Department of Health, were to receive funds for the Breast and Cervical Cancer Act, then that money would be used to prevent breast and cervical cancer and not used for elective abortions. Or if they receive monies from the Minority HIV and AIDS Initiative, that it is spent to prevent HIV and AIDS and not used for elective abortions. House Bill 294 also lists two additional federal funds, and those are the Infertility Prevention Project of the CDC and the Violence Against Women Act of 1994. House Bill 294 also states in lines 79 through 82 that, quote, all state funds to OVH include infant mortality reduction or infant vitality initiative funds, and that they are not to be used to perform or promote elective abortions, nor to contract with some other entity, nor to become an affiliate with another entity who performs or promotes elective abortions. Our infant mortality reduction funds are intended to reduce the number of children who don't reach their first birthday. Currently, our state is ranked 47th in the nation for infant mortality. There were over 1,000 Ohio infant deaths in 2012 alone. And yet we had over 12,000 abortions in Ohio last year. We need to focus our healthcare tax dollars on saving babies. Why do I feel so passionately about this? I'll tell you a personal story. My father was an OBGYN who delivered babies for almost 50 years. I grew up living right next to a hospital so that he could go over and deliver a baby and make it home in time for dinner. It seemed like every dinner table conversation was about delivering babies, and in excruciating detail, my siblings and I got to hear about that. Whether it was stillborn births, Siamese twins, or the many, many healthy baby boys and girls that he delivered and brought into the world. So I guess you could just say I'm intrinsically pro-life, and that's why I don't want my tax dollars used to pay for abortions. Many people in the media refer to this legislation as the Defund Planned Parenthood Bill. But there is no mention of any particular abortion provider in our bill. House Bill 294 states that if ODH receives money that I just described, that it just not be used for elective abortions. Some people have also argued that this legislation would harm the funding of women's health, but I don't see it that way. I see it as helping women and children by focusing the dollars on staying healthy. There are 208 healthcare facilities that accept Medicaid patients in the state of Ohio, in both rural and urban areas, and that's 10 times the number of Planned Parenthood facilities in the state. There is no shortage of healthcare in Ohio. We're blessed in that way. People have also asked, well, how much money will House Bill 294 divert from abortion providers? And we, each and every one of us on this committee and in the audience, can look that up. Our treasurer has a new website, it's ohiocheckbook.com, and we looked up for Planned Parenthood to see that they received $1.3 million in 2014 from ODH. You too can look that up, and you can look for other providers and see how much money they received from